This conference will.
Okay, so thanks everyone for joining this particular webinar. So in this webinar, what we are going to discuss and all, first I'll explain you the agenda of this particular training. Okay, then after we will start our content. Right, so agenda of the webinar, so today's 1 hour, it's a short training, because if it is a 2 hours, means you can discuss a lot, but I'm planning to conduct so in future also the continuation sessions will be there, so you are good to attend it. So in today's session we are going to discuss about DFSAT, okay, and you know how to write a DFSAT statement, okay, the syntaxes part, statements and sort fields. Okay, there are different control cards are there. Sort fields, today's will be introductory part. Okay, sort fields, then match, then we have something called include. Okay, so these are all the things we are going to discuss, because so 50 minutes I'm going to take, last 10 minutes I'm going to take questions from your end. Okay, so if you have any queries, please park them, so we can, I can take up in the end of the training, because it's a public it's open webinar. So they, you know, if you start with discussing the doubts and queries, it will take more than 5 to 10 minutes, but within a 1 hour it is difficult for us to spend 10 minutes for one particular part. So that is the reason what I am doing for this particular webinar. So first I will complete the theoretical and hands-on part. At the end I will ask you, you know, I will take your all questions and I will give you the answers. This is the planting, right? So right, right. So let's, without any delay, let's start our content. So what is DFSAT? Okay. So to attend this webinar, you should have knowledge on introduction to mainframe and at least JCL basics. Whether you know COBOL, DB2, CSS, that is not important for this particular to understand DFSAT. If you are having mainframe knowledge, that is more enough to attend this webinar. So what is DFSAT? Okay, so what we can do with a DFSAT, why it is a powerful, see, there are so many topics are there in mainframe, but why I am choosing, even last time I have chosen, I have delivered on iStool, this time I am delivering on DFSAT. So which means that there is a, you know, there are a lot of things you can do on DFSAT and iStool, and interview purpose also it will help you a lot. Okay, so in this context, okay, so to face interviews on DFSAT and iStool, and to get in a clear picture, so that if you get an idea what is DFSAT, what is iStool, so you can able to implement even in your project also if you get, you know, any requirement. So some people might be having knowledge on the DFSAT, iStool, but still I want, there are so many people having little bit knowledge, so because you don't get chance to work on it, but when you go for interview they might be asking on DFSAT. That is the reason I have chosen this topic to conduct as a webinar. Okay, so right, so DFSAT, we have DFSAT is there, and iStool, okay, or iStool. So these two utilities are to sort the data. So if you want to process any existing data, that you can do easily with a DFSAT or iStool. Okay, so what are the things you can do with the DFSAT and iStool? I will give an introduction part. So first you need to understand what is DFSAT or iStool, what is the need of it. Okay, first I'll talk about what is, why, where, how. So all WH questions, first I will answer for all WH questions. So what is DFSAT? It is an utility to process existing data. Again, I'm repeating, it is a utility similar to IEB gener, IEB copy, ID cams, IEH list is there, okay, IE edit is there. So like that, how we are having utilities for DFSAT also. DFSAT is one of the IBM supplied utility to sort or to process the data. This is all about what is DFSAT. Why we required? Okay, so that is the next question. So team, if I want to copy the data from one sequential file to another sequential file, based on some condition. Okay, let's take an example. We are having a file called customers data. The data is all about customers: customer number, customer name, customer location, customer balance. Like that, we are having different fields are there. Now, how we can copy only Indian customer details into another file? How we can copy the data from one file to another file if the customer is belongs to in India? There are two ways to do it. You can do through program, there is no doubt in that, or we can write a utility also, because you can able to serve the requirement with the help of the COBOL without any SORT. We don't need to use SORT in COBOL. The another one is you can use utility. Okay, so we can use it. Okay, so when you want to do all of them, you can use DF SORT. This is the one. And next one, okay, so if you want to sort the data, there are different ways to do it. Again, here also there are different ways. One is you can do through JCL utility, that is DF SORT iStud. The second approach is in COBOL also we have a sort verb is there. Okay, we have a COBOL sort verb is there, but to do this part in COBOL program, okay, it is a lengthy process, it's a lengthy step. If you are want to sort through program, you have to write, you have to declare three files. One is input file, work file, output file. You need to declare the file section for all of them. You need to write the sort verb in the COBOL program, and you need to do compilation to run JCL. So why we need to do all these steps when we are having a flexible, easiest step to do the same, to implement, to complete the same requirement? Okay, so if somebody asks you in interview, can we sort through program, through COBOL program? Answer is yes. How we can do it if the cross question comes? The answer again, sort is the web in COBOL program. Okay, so this is the example thing. So most of the clients will ask, or your manager, so your managers will ask you to, you can use DF sort. Okay, the restrictions are very less, because in most of the projects they will use DF sort iStud for common functionalities. Right. Okay, so this is the interactivity part. Now what else we can do? Okay, so if you ask me what we can do it, so if you want to sort the data, okay, if you want to sort the data, we can do sorting, or you want to copy the data from one file to another file, that we can do easily. Okay, that we can do. So we can copy the data from one file to another file based on condition. Example I have given, I want to copy the data from one file to another file if the customer belongs to India. Okay, so this is the one we can do it. So we, if you want to reformat, these are all frequently used concepts team. Okay, so there are 900 pages document is there on DF sort. There are 900 pages document is there, but we cannot discuss all 900 pages concept. But which are frequently will be used, which are all the things you should know as a mainframe resource. Okay, as a mainframe resource, as a mainframe developer or supporting, what you should know, those are all the things we are covering, right? So how you can reformat the record? So what does mean team? So you have a file like customer number, customer name, customer address, customer balance. Now the client wants to copy the data, the client wants to copy the data, customer name, customer balance, then customer name number. So they don't want to process all the fields at the same time, they don't want to go with the same order, so they want to reformat it. If you want to reformat the data, you can do it. Then if you want to copy the data from one file to many files, okay, based on different conditions. Then condition, then we can go with that. So I want to copy the data from one file to many files, which means that there is a file which has all countries customer details. Now the client want to maintain all Indian customer details should be Indian related data center, all the work belongs to the America, so USA, their customer, the USA customer details should be kept in another file. So they want to separate them. In that case, how you can do it? So we can do with the help of DFSort easily. Next one, if you want to reformat the data, if you want to generate the reports, this is a very good thing. If you want to generate the reports, okay, so generating the reports, what type of the reports you can generate in? You are seeing the payslips, you are seeing the bank statement, Paytm statements. If you want to do all of them, that you can do easily using DFSort. Okay, that you can do using DFSort. So we can, there are so many webs are there too. So these are all the major things which we do it. If you want to merge the data, that also we can do it. Okay. So like that, if I keep on typing, so it will take half an hour to explain what we can do with the DFSort. Okay, right. So this is the introduction part related to DFSort. Now, let me explain. Okay, so how you can do sorting, as I told you. So how to write the DFSort in JSON? What are the control cards? How do you write it? How do you do sorting the data? How do you merge? Include what are the conditions are there when you're writing the code? How do you fix if you get an error? Those are all the things we are going to discuss now. So whenever you are writing a control card tip or control card of the DFSort control card, we have some specific rules. Okay, so we have a specific rules on how internally it works. If you ask me, Venkat, I have so many in a single control card, I'm using so many keywords, like I am using skip break, I'm using include, okay, I'm using, so in the same control card I'm using omit. There are somewhere here and there you might be using it, stop after, you're using inrec, or you're using outrec. Okay, so you're using start rec, then you're using end rec, and so on. So when you write all the combination of the control card, all the statement, all the parameters in the one control card, how it is going to work? So do we have any flow? Do we have any priorities? Yes. Okay, so let me explain you that part. Okay, so this is, you might be knowing how to write the control card, but you will learn this option very, we generally don't focus on this part. Okay, so let me explain you to the flow of this. So I'm going to explain, I'm going to take one by one here. So eventually, if anything is required, I'll use it. So first, you will be given in the control part first. Sorting team. So if you want to sort the data, ideally you are supposed to mention your input data. Sorting will be your input data set. So that particular data set will be passing to the skip break. Okay, you are having any skip break combination. Skip break part is going to play the key role. Then after, if you are having any combination control card with the include or omit, because omit include almost both are same. Include means it will include the data, omit means it will discard. Okay, so then we have something else called stop after. Okay, so stop after, so we can, after that we have something else called inrec. Okay, inrec, then we have something called sort or sum or copy. Okay, so these are all the priorities. Okay, this is the order how it will be executed. The next thing, so we are having output. Okay, So outfield, it has some, again, so many components are there in outfield. So we have start, rec, okay, end rec, then sample. So the, all the things come into the picture tip when you write all these combination parameters in a single control card. So how it works, that is we are discussing. Then, so we are having include, already we written include, right? So the over save is there, okay? Save, omit, already we written that also. Save is there. Then next, overlay, okay? So we have something called the split. These are all the control cards splitting the data. Split by, okay, so split by. So like this, there are so many control cards are there. Now the flow is something. First your sorting will be going this. After skipping the records, then it will be passed to include or move. After including, the data will be passed to stop after erect. Then after skipping, after filtering the data by these control cards, it goes to the outfield. Then from outfield, it is going to pass it to save. Okay. So from here, it goes to the output data set. Okay. So this is how it will go out. This is how it is going to execute the control card thing. Okay. If you are having parameters, these are all you can consider as a parameters in the start utility. So when you write all these combinations, okay, we may not write all of them, but if you write mix randomly, if you mix according to your business requirement, then you will get a question. Okay, so which is executing first, which is executing now? So these are all the things you face when you don't get the desired output, because you are generating a report but you are not getting the desired output. Then we will focus and we will think, okay, why it is not coming, where it is going wrong. Okay, so these are all the things you will be searching, and you do R&D. So in that time you should know the entire flow of it. Okay, how the order is going to take. Okay, team. So this is all about the flow of your control cards execution. Now, so we after this thing, so let's see how you can write the control card. Okay, what is the syntax? Right. So I'll be writing the rough example here. Team. Later, okay. So I will write on the mainframe. So first, in any code, job card will be there, team, with respect to your utility you are using. Then step one. Okay, step name, execute PCM is equal to sort. Sort is the utility. Okay, what is it? Sort is the utility. So instead of, we can, sort utility can be called as a df sort also. Okay, so sort. And when you are writing the sort utility, team, there are mandatory DD names are there. Sys sort out. Okay, this DD name is mandatory. So where you are redirecting the output, that is choice is yours. You want to redirect the output or sort out data to the file or spool, choice is yours. Then we have sort in. This is the another DD name. Okay. Sort out. This is another DD name. Sort exam. Sort off. Sort off. 01, sort of 02, sort in NN, sort in NN. Okay, so let me explain you thing. When you are writing the DM sort utility, we will be writing the control card, right? The control card will be like sysin dd star. So here the writing all control cards. So in the control card, okay, in control card, if any error occur related to sort utility, those errors will be printed in sort out dd name. So I'm repeating again, you are writing control cards here. If any control card, anything is wrong, anything goes wrong, then those error description messages will be printed sort out. It is going to print the sort out. So if any errors are there in the JCL syntax, it will be printed in JESMSG, okay, MSGLG log, job entry system message log. So it will be printed in the how we have a rule for syntax. Similarly, when you're writing the control chart, if something went wrong in the control chart, those statements, description of the error will be printed in the sort out. If this DD name is missing, okay, it is a mandatory DD statement. If you miss this statement, you will get maximum condition code 20. So immediately, whenever you get maximum 20, first your target whether sort out DD statement is present or not. Okay, if it is a present, then we can look for other things. But simple first step, this statement should be there. Next, sort in is to specify your input data set. Okay, where is your input data set? So the data set name should be mentioned on the sort in DD name. After sorting the data, after processing the data, we want to copy. So it should be copied into the output data set. So sort in is a predefined DD name. All DD names whichever I have written, all are it should be a sysout. It is not a sort out, it is a sysout. Okay, so sysout DD name manager. Next thing, sort out. Okay, sort in to specify input data set, which data you want to process, the file location, output data set, then sort XM. Okay, sort XM is if you want to eliminate the duplicates, then eliminate the data or process the data you want to copy, you can go with the sort XM. So that is all about. If you want to do merging, okay, if you are merging thing, you can go with the sort in. And let's say I want to merge two data sets or three data sets, then I will go with the sort in NN. NN means 01. So for merging purpose, I will go with the sort in is DD. Next, sort of 01, sort of 02. So these are all output files. Okay, output file 1. This is output file 2. So where it is required? Did you remember? I explained a statement. We can copy the data from one file to many files. If we want to copy to the many files, then those output files should be these are all. Okay. So like this, there are so many other predefined DD names are also there. So but I have listed only few of them. Here I have listed only a few of them. Okay. So sysout, sort in, sort out, and so on. Okay. So let me show you everything. Let me show you everything on the mainframe ID. So I'm going to first. Already created a one PDF sheet to write the JSON. I will be writing here. Yes, start one. Okay, I'm creating a one member. So METERN. Okay, this the job card accounting information. So Venkat notify Amberson. User ID. Step one, as I told you, first we have to write the sort utility, then sysout DD statement is mandatory. I will comment and I will show you the output also, what the error comes, how do you figure out it, how do you fix it, how do you know that is a mistake, and all I'll explain. Sort in DD sysout, we need to specify input data set name. So I will create input data set in front of your team, then sort out to copy the data DD DSN is equal. Then after sorting, based on you want to sort based on some condition, so control card needs to be mentioned within the CCNDD statement. Okay, so CCNDD star. So here you can mention control card team. So here you can mention control part. Okay, so these are all the skeleton part, skeleton EFSART utility. I will be creating a one. I'm creating a one file, sequential file. So start, I will be inserting the data as well as. I created a file with the 80 record length, okay, 8800. So let me insert the data thing. So call number. I'm going with the, okay, so 1001, okay. So what is the important point in when you are doing sorting? You should understand, you should know where which field is starting. Okay, so what is the field, what is the data type of the field, starting position and ending position, the length of it. So these are all very important. So I am going to take this format data. Okay, so anyhow it's 80 record length. So I will go with the customer number, customer name, customer address, customer address, customer balance. Okay, so let's go with the 5. So simply go with the 2020, balance will be 8. So I don't give any additional space. So the starting position will be a 1. So this will be 25. So till 25 log 26 46, 53, 54, I guess. Correct. So these are the starting positions. So 1, 5, 6, 20. Yeah. So I'm going to start the name. I'm going to give name Divya. So first 5 bytes occupied by the customer number, then 20. So already 25 bytes occupied by name, number and name. So 26 I'm giving address. I will go with the states Bangalore. Okay, I'll go with the Bangalore. So again it is also 20 characters length. I'm assuming it that way. So or we will go with the better we go with the 3 characters. It'll be easy for us. State short code. Okay, so 16 520, right, it will be 26, it will be 3, okay, BAN, and 26 plus the 3 byte. So from 29, I need to start, from 29 I'm starting balance, okay, 00. So what is the size? I am going with 8000, 8 digit. So yeah, it will be a 10,000 now. Okay, so it will be a 10,000. Now we got the size, the position. I am repeating 10 times. So I am going to change data 6 or 20, 18, okay, 16, 5, 3. 4, 2, 9. Okay, so randomly I have inserted the data thing. Okay, so I'm going to change the data. So Divya and Devi, Mohit. Okay, so Mohit, Mitali. Okay, Rohit, Sachin, Ravid. Okay, so Tony. So please, okay, if I don't add your favorite cricketer name, please, okay, ignore me that. We can add something else. Shahir, okay. Mehra. Bitu. Okay, so I'm going to change हैदराबाद। अच्छा तो हैदराबाद, मुंबई, मुंबई, सो बेंगलोर, सो चेन्नई, मुंबई, DGL, DGL, okay. Okay, team. So we have to change the values also because our, you know, we need to give the proper data to make. Okay, team. So if you notice, in our input file, the data is not in a sorted order. Okay. The data is not in a sorted order. So how we can do? First of all, I need to specify the input data set. So I'm going to specify here. So provide input data set against the sorting disposition share. Then sort out equal star. So what I'm doing, team, I'm redirecting the output to the school. I'm redirecting the output to the school. If you want to copy the data into output file, that you can do it. But I, you know, anyhow, I'm going to show the errors and all in the school. Okay, so I can save
Venkat,
some time.
Venkat, don't you think it should be sort out DD sys out equal to star?
Yeah, I'll change it. Yeah.
Okay.
Correct. Okay. So team, the first control card I'm going to use. Okay, sort fields is equal to copy. So here we are not doing any sorting. Simple, what is the one functionality of the sort utility? You can copy the data from one file to another file as it is without sorting, which is equivalent to IEB gener. Okay, IEB gener also will help you to copy the sequential data from one file to another file. So that is what we are doing. Save and submit. So whenever, very important thing, whenever you are submitting the JCL, if you are using any input file or output file, those files should be closed. Why the notification is not coming? The reason, the input file I open in another place. Now you can see you got the output immediately. Okay, so very important. Now I'm going to the spool. Sort out. Okay, the data is not in a sorted order. Now how I have inserted in the same format, data also is copied. It is output, right? Now I will show you something by commenting sys out. As I told you, it will throw max C20 if the sys out is missing. Okay. So maximum condition code 20, that is sys out is missing. What I do, team, I will show you where it went wrong. You can see sys out DD statement is missing. Okay, so very important, that is mandatory whenever you're writing. Whenever you're writing a sort, sys out is mandatory. Whenever you're writing IED CAMS or IEB gener, sys print is mandatory. Okay, so if you're having experience on that, how sys print is mandatory for ID CAMS and IEB gener, for sort utility, sys out DD statement is mandatory. Right.
Venkat, I have a question here.
Yeah, can you park the question? I'll take at the end.
Okay.
I told you starting only, because if I take the questions half of the time, it takes more for that only, because we will get another question from that question. Okay, so I have already allocated some time, so it's okay. I'm going to take more than 1 hour also if it is required, so I'm okay with that. Okay, sort is a called. Okay, I want to sort the data. Okay, so I want to sort the data based on the customer number. So customer number, what is the syntax thing to sort the database run any condition? Sort fields is equal to starting position of the field, the length of the field, then data type of the field, what is the next thing? Either you want ascending order or descending order. Okay, this is the syntax of sort fields thing, where you want to sort the data, but it should be a specific field, right? So even in your writing SQL query, we write order by the column name. Similarly, sort fields based on the column name, so our field name, the field starting position, length. Okay, where is the ending position? It is not important. It is not required in the control part. Okay, but you should know both of them. Now I know that it is starting first position, length is 5. Okay, that is how I have the data, and data type is CH, then A. I will talk about the data type. Okay, so I'll explain you one by one. So starting position is 1. From 1, it is going to take 5 bytes. Whatever the first 5 bytes is there, based on that data, is going to sort it since it's a character data. Save and submit. So you need to, how you can comment control parting, just to mention star on the first column. So that will be commented. So sort out. So very important thing, the output will be in the sort out. Okay. So because I told you, right, sort out is the output data set. So why it is coming to the spool? Because we are redirecting output to the spool. Now you can see, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 2 names are there with the files, 6, 9, 16, 18, 20. Okay, so this is how you can do sort based on the condition. Now I am doing explicitly some mistake tip, intentionally I am doing an error, so that you will come to know how to fix the error as well. Submit, you got max is 16. So go to the spool. Type sysout. Okay, sysout. Always, I told you, right, if any error is related to sort utility, straight away those errors are going to redirect to sysout. That is the reason you are able to see errors in this sysout. Now it is showing a dollar symbol, means on the above dollar line nearby. Okay, it is going to give dollar near to that particular area. So something went wrong. That is the reason it is giving a dollar. Now I'm going to save and submit. You got a 0. Okay. So anyhow, we have seen it already. Let's take an example thing. Sometimes what happened, you got input data. Okay. So I will be opening in a browse mode. So your customer numbers are same. Okay. Maybe customer numbers might be in a queue, but there are some cases your first field data is same, then you want to start based on the second field. You want to start based on the second field. So if that is the case, what you can do, team, comma, my next field starting position, the length of it, and what is the data type of it, what order you want. So in our case, all numbers are unique. Okay, all data is everything, you know, customer numbers are unique. So you don't get the total, practically don't get it, but you know, if I change the input data, you will be able to get it. So this is the example, how do you sort the data based on the fields. So control always goes to the second field when in the first field data is duplicate. If that first row in the first field data is not a duplicate, then it is not going to copy. Okay, I mean, or it is not going to, sorry, it is not going to, control is not going to second field. So that is the behavior of it. Next, we have, there are different variations are there, team. Sort fields is equal to, I know that the format is the same. Okay, I know that format is same. So instead of writing multiple times CH, 1 comma 5 comma A, 6 comma 20 comma A, format CH. So in this way also you can do a So we got zero. So output you will get it. Okay. So what you can understand from this example team, you can write separate parameter like a format. Okay, you can write a format. So I am going to give D in a descending order. So we will try how descending is going to work. So I like to see sort out. Okay. Is it copied? No, right. What I did mistake is I have written a D in the second fill because control anyhow it will not come to the second fill. Make the first fill as a descending order.
So that you will get the output. So one is in descending order, second one is ascending order. So any choice is combination is yours. Okay. We don't have any restriction to do. Okay, team. So the data is in sorted order. Okay, team. So the next very important is data type. Okay. So generally, whenever I ask anyone who are having resource, who are having experience on JSCL with SART, I'll ask you the data types. Okay. So they will start confusing, or they might cross question me, what are the data types? How you need to mention the data type, in which situation, which data type needs to be mentioned. Since character means it's alphanumeric, it can take numbers data, it can take characters, combination of them. That is the reason always you can go with the CH. But there are some cases you want to do a sum. If you want to do a sum, 100% go to mention numeric data type. Okay, so in that case, CH will not help. If you are doing sorting CH, you mentioned still it is working, right? But there are some cases you want to sort, or you want to do sum, you want to reformat with a numeric, you want to do addition calculation, you want to do on the integer data, then you have to mention other than character data. So what are the data types are there? We have something called CH, which is equivalent to, in COBOL, we mentioned pick X of something, correct? So wherever X data type is there in COBOL, okay, just I'm, but since already you might be knowing COBOL, that is the reason I'm writing. So if you are having X, nothing but alphanumeric data type, so that data you can mention as a character, right? Next, if your data is pick 9 of 10, so n of 9 means 6, 7, 6, like that. So when your data is in this format, you can mention insert ZD, okay, donor decimal. You can mention donor decimal. Then we are having pick, okay, yes, 9 now. The data will be like this, E9, and sign is leading, separate something. In that case, I can go with the CSL or FS. Okay, so FS is nothing but integer data, 0 or 1. Okay, that position should have 0 or 1, something like this. Now, if you are having the data types in COBOL, pick 9 of n, comp, or it's a comp data type, or comp 4, okay, or comp 5. Okay, these are all the computational usage classes in COBOL. When we are having this combination of data, better you mention binary. BI. Next, when you are having the data, okay, so when you are having data in comp 3, pick S9 of 4 comp 3, you have to mention packer decimal. Very important is unit decimal, binary, packer decimal, and character. So if you see here and there, max, you will be seeing only these 4 data types. Okay, so but we are having something else also. So we have a comp 1. Okay, so for that you will mention FL, even comp 2. Okay, you will use FL data types. Your data is comp 2, your file comp 2 data type is there. Better you have to use the control part FL, comp 1 FL. Okay, so based on the data, okay, based on your actual input data, based on that, in the control part, you have to choose the right data type and do sorting. Okay, so this is all about the data types. Okay, team. So this is about how you can do sorting the data from one file to another file. Let me explain you the another example. Okay, so I'm going to explain you another example, that is how you can do merge. Okay, so I'm copying this data, okay, so to another file, because if you want to do merge, okay, if you want to do merge, we need a minimum two files. One minute, team. I'll be back. 1 minute. Give me 1 minute. Okay, so what I did, I copied the data. Let me change the data. Okay, so what I'm doing, let's say I'm changing it to okay, so 2 2 3 4 5 1 2. Okay, so I, you know, prefix the first number is different, but rest of the data remains. Now how do you do merge? Okay, so can you give me the answer, the difference between concordination in IEB general? Can you give me the answer, difference between concordination in IEB general and merging? Quickly give me the answer. So can I get the answer?
I think in case of merge, data will get in one file, but in case of concatenation, will not get the data in single file.
Okay.
Concatenation means.
Yeah, go ahead.
Two files merging to one single file.
Okay, what about merge then?
Merge means the different record length.
No,
different record length fields are merging.
No. Okay, so team, the concordination is nothing but, okay, it's like appending. Okay, first let's say there are three files data is there. Okay, so let's take an example. There is a file, three files data. First file data will be here. Okay, so whether data is in sorted order, it doesn't care in the concordination. Okay, let's say till this F1 data. Then if you are merging second file, okay, so this is F2 data. So F3. So in concordination also, three files data will be there in the output file in a single file. But whichever the order you mentioned, first file data will be there immediately next, and after first last record of the first file, it'll second file data, then after third file data. So it is going to altogether, it is going to concordinate without any merging, I mean without sorting. Okay, the core important point is here, just appending first file data, then second file append, third file append it. That is called concordination. So whenever you use IEB general, this is the output you will get it. this is the output you will get. But okay, what about merge? Merge means thing, it is going to mix all the numbers. Okay, what I said earlier, concordination is nothing but appending the data. Here it is not appending according to the custom numbers, it is going to merge it. Okay, so in a sorted manner. So I'll show you practically. Okay, so what I will do, let me specify the input file. This is our input file. So always when you are merging the data, if we use same utility, we use sort in 01. That is very important. Disposition share, then sort out, sorry, sort in 02. This is again to merge second file. So we will get an error. So the way I am writing, so for that I will get an error, but I want to show it. That is intentionally I'm making sort out DD sysout equal star. Now sysin DD star. Okay, so we are going to use a control called merge fields. I want to sort based on the customer number. That is the reason. Starting position of the customer number 1, the length of it 5, data type CH, ascending order. Save and submit. So we are getting 16. I'll tell you before I show you the error message. Whenever you are doing merging thing, in this file, data is in sorted order. First check it. Data is not in a sorted order. Okay, because it's in a next. If I go to second file, in this file, data is sorted order. No. So what is the conclusion, team? Whenever you are doing merging, all the files independently, okay. If you talk about file 1, it should be in a sorted order. If you seeing the file 2, it in base sorted order. So for merge, the base rule is the record length should be same, record format should be same. Because if you add other parameters, then record length format can be different. It is not a mandatory, but the data should be in a sorted order when you look into any specific file of the merge inputs. So we want to see the error messages. Sort out. So F8, you can see out of sequence. Okay, there is a message out of sequence sort in 01. Right. So now what we need to do, so what I will do, I'll hard code the value because I don't want to again do sorting and let's, I'll take the input data from here. I will paste it. Okay, so just I will take 4 rows for the both files. Okay, so let's see 1, 3, 5, 6 in sorted order. I will go with the odd numbers. 1 is there, 3 is there, 5, 7. So here I will go even numbers 2, 4, 6, 6 and 8. So please focus, don't think about when you are doing, when you are checking, you should focus in this file data is in sorted order or not, since we are going with the first 5 positions. Yeah, first 5 positions data is sorted order. In the second one also the data is in a sorted order, so everything is fine, looks good, right? Now this is the one is required. Okay, so whether order, it we should be in order, that's all. Okay, what number is there, that we don't need to take care. So we got maxus is 60. Or did you find anywhere
of the sorting 0 to DD star should be given? Fine. You have given data set.
So we got maxus 0. Let's go to the spool because there is the output. Okay, because we redirected the output, the spool. So now can you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is merged, right? But if you talk about concatenation, first it will be copied at the end. This data will be there. That is the main difference between them. Okay. So if somebody asks you the difference between concatenation merge, merge is there in the sort utility. You need minimum 2 files. Both how many files you are using for merge, all the files independently in a sorted order. If all the files in sorted order, it is okay, perfectly fine. It works. Okay, record length and format should be also same when you are going with the simple syntax. Okay, so this is all about. Okay, team. So now you can ask me queries. Okay, so in another session, I will be explaining. Okay, so in future, I am going to plan few more sessions on the DFSAT. This is the webinar one you can consider on DFSAT. Series will be there, okay, it's two, because we discussed the basics. So shortly I will schedule the second one. The second one will be on, okay, so we discussed, I know I thought of discussing include also in today's session, but I could not. So I will be explaining include, and we use await, outfill, three control cards I will take in another demo. Okay, so that's all from my end for this webinar team. So now you can ask me questions if you are having anything. And one more thing, if anybody wants to join the mainframe mentoring, you can reach out to me. So, okay. So I'll help you if you need any mainframe mentoring, because we are starting mainframe mentoring training tomorrow. So this is my contact number. You have joined directly, you can get it from here. Yeah. So please. Kailas, I guess you might be having
doubt. Yes.
Hi Venkat, can you please explain what is indirect trick?
Yeah, we will take it, okay. So in now one day we cannot take all of it. So let's take in another day.
Okay, fine.
See, if I want to give in a high level, indirect and outrect to reformat the record structures, okay. So why we need both of them? You want to sort, I mean, you want to reformat before sorting or after sorting. Okay. So both, basically both are to serve the same, reformatting the record structure. So you want to reformat after doing a sorting or before sorting. So based on this point, you are going to get the difference between indirect and outrect.
Okay. Thank you.
Hello Venkat.
So team, and one more, if you want to get few more our webinars, okay, you can send me WhatsApp on this number, okay, so automatically you will be getting notifications from my end.
Hi Venkat, I have a question.
Yeah.
While merging the data, so can we use two sort conditions? Like earlier, how you showed, one is descending order and one is ascending order. So like that, can we use it here? Or we have that option.
One is descending order, right? You're saying.
Yes, one is descending and one is ascending. As earlier you showed, right? So like that, can we use the merge fields? Or?
Yeah, I'm showing directly now. Okay. So.
I think Venkatesh's question is, can we use two fields in the merge
yes, control card? Yes, can be done. If that is your question, yes, you can do it.
Yes.
Venkat, sort field is equal to copy. Is it sorting the file or is jumping the data?
Just simple copy. It's a simple copy. No sorting. No sorting will happen there. Yeah.
Okay.
So any queries, Steve? Do you have any queries? Let me stop the recording.